Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. Today let's take a look at the Assistive Touch menu on your iPhone. MacMost is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 600 supporters just like you. Go to MacMost.com/Patreon. There you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So the Assistive Touch menu is something you can use on your iPhone or iPad to access functions that normally take a little bit more than just tapping the screen. For instance, you may need to use a gesture or press one of the physical buttons on your phone to accomplish a task. Let's take a look at how to turn it on. Go to Settings and then go down to Accessibility. From there, go to Touch. And then you'll see Assistive Touch at the top. Go in there and you can turn it on. Now you see that white circle inside of a black circle? That's the Assistive Touch menu. You can see it fades away after a few seconds, but it remains on the screen. Now you can drag this around to put it anywhere on the screen that you want. It snaps to the left or right side of the screen very easily. So you can drag it around, but it's always going to try to snap to the closest side. And then after a few seconds it'll fade so you can see what's underneath it. So the idea is it's there and you see it, but it can kind of stay out of the way when you're not using it. Now what it does depends on your settings. If you look under Custom Actions here, you can see there's Single Tap, Double Tap, and Long Press. And you could set an action to happen for any one of those. For Single Tap, you see I have it set to Open Menu. Let's go and look at that. You can see here the top one is None. Open Menu is second. And then there's a whole bunch of other ones. So you can set it to a specific action. For instance, setting it to Control Center will bring up Control Center if I tap it. So instead of using the gesture to drag down from the upper right hand corner to bring up Control Center, you could just tap this button. You can also set it to Home and then it would act as a Home button. Matter of fact, you can even drag it down to the middle and it will stay there and it will feel like it's an actual Home button. Now when you have it set to Open Menu, what it's going to do is give you a menu of choices including many of the options here. So you'll have other ways to get to some of these functions. The function list is pretty long and includes a lot of accessibility things, but also includes Siri shortcuts. So you can create your own Siri shortcuts and they'll appear here in this list. So now that I have Single Tap set to Open Menu, I can try it. I'm going to give it a single tap and it brings up this menu. So this menu includes by default 6 different items. And I can just now tap on one of these items to get to any one of them. For instance, if I'm going to get to Control Center, I can tap Control Center and it brings it up. So instead of using the Control Center gesture, I can now tap once on the Assistive Touch button and then tap on Control Center. 2 taps will do it. Other options here include Siri. So instead of having to press and hold the side button, I can bring Siri up this way. And also I have a Home button there, which I can use instead of my actual physical Home button, or in this case, the little bar at the bottom of the screen. Now 2 of these buttons will actually lead to more options. If I hit Device, it gives me some iPhone related options here, like volume up and volume down. So here's a way to control volume without actually using the physical buttons on your phone. There's also lock screen, rotate screen, and a mute button. And there's also a more button there. I can tap that. And now I can see ways to get to the app switcher, take a screenshot, trigger the SOS function, even simulate a shake or Apple Pay. There's even a restart there as well. Notice the little back arrow in the middle. I can tap that to go back one screen and again to go back to this screen. Also the custom button there, that will allow me to choose from a couple of gestures, like for instance the long press or a double tap. So if I were to use one of those, say a double tap, it gives me this circle on the screen here and I could tap anywhere just once, but it will actually give me a double tap instead of a single tap in that spot. I turn it off by simply tapping the Assistive Touch button again. Now I can customize this as much as I want. See where it says Customize Top Level Menu? If I tap there, you can see those 6 buttons. I could subtract one or add one. I hit the plus button here, I can add one, and you could see it just has a little plus button there. I can tap it. And now here's that list again, minus the items that are already active somewhere. So I could pick something else from this list and use that. So for instance, if I wanted to add a screenshot there, I can. And now screenshot is that extra 7th button. And now whenever I tap there, you could see it comes up as another option on the screen. So you can go in here and you can also customize the existing buttons. So I can hit, say, the notifications button there and pick something else other than notifications to fill that slot. I can also subtract the most recent items I've added, and if I ever want to, I'll hit the reset button and it's going to reset it to the default set. Now under custom actions I can go and turn off single tap for this and instead make it a double tap. for open menu. So now I have to tap twice to bring that up. So you have that as an option. And you can also do it as long press instead. If ever you want to turn this off, just return to this section of settings and you can switch this off. You could also ask Siri, turn Assistive Touch on.
Okay, I turned on Assistive Touch.
Turn Assistive Touch off.
Okay, I turned off Assistive Touch.
Now there are a few different reasons you may want to use this. One, of course, is if you do have difficulty using some of the gestures on the screen or using the physical buttons. That's what it's really made for. But it also can help in other situations where using those is difficult. For instance, if you put a case on it, maybe a waterproof case or something super protective, and you can't quite use the physical buttons and you can't easily do gestures on the screen, it might be easier to have these as simple buttons that you could tap once, twice, or three times to get to the function you want. Other people may just prefer actually seeing a button, tapping a button to get to functionality, than remembering all the different gestures. And also, of course, I've seen this used a lot when an iPhone's getting old and starting to break down. I've seen people with old iPhones where the home button doesn't work anymore and Assistive Touch has allowed them to continue using it because they can use the button as a home button or access home through there. The same with volume buttons as well. They're able to access the volume using Assistive Touch even though maybe the volume buttons on their iPhone have failed. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.